So, Jared got this fucking thing running again. It's kind of embarrassing how easy it was for him. I just think this particular piece of equipment has a fondness of its owner and is quite uneasy with me. Sort of, you know, how cats don't like to be pet by anyone else, but they're really sweet. This thing's really sweet and doesn't like me. So I've been trying to fucking till this goddamn thing myself, and he won't let me do it. So. Anyway, you missed about 30 minutes of, well, maybe, it probably took Jared 10 minutes to get it going, but there's probably 30 minutes of just like, well, what the fuck's happening? And, yeah, so I'm trying, I want to at least, like, do a row. Well, I did two rows, but I want to fix things up. Thank you.
was a fairly small fire pit. It was not really a tree.
Yeah, right here.
Like, yep.
Maybe half the size of the
yeah.
Your spot. A little tighter. Some big rocks we can just lug in from the river or something.
Yeah, you do that little power thing like that?
Yeah.
throwing one.
I moved her pots down. She's gonna put some trees down. She's got a big tree. She's an animal. What this is.
Blackberry or?
Yeah, blackberry. She was talking about making sure she had some blackberry. These things perked up. They need some water. I always just water the piss out of them today.
This is another rose of Sharon here. I just keep hitting these things. Eventually they'll die, but it'll take years. And there, like,
yeah,
it's
a
what's the one that has an ivy of some sort of...
It's got this crazy purple leaves.
Oh, it's clematis.
I think I had that growing up on the side of the house.
Fucking purple flowers like that.
Amazing.
That's a pretty flower, right?
But it's pretty aggressive too.
You could dare or put a little trellis on that fence right there. Just be your friend. But boom bop up there.
You see me the tree there? This is untreated, that's kind of it's fresh.
Eventually it'll kind of gray and vertical like that, nine times that.
Yeah, that's one of the best.
Eventually, I mean, if I'm in the but when it is, after that, probably won't be much here, but
yeah, you get a bucket out of it every few days.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
Trying to do some like bonsai of sorts with these guys. Those are oaks that I just left pots out on the fucking porch. Acorns got in there and fucking
that's cool.
Came up, so it's like, alright.
See how you want to live, huh?
Let's see how tough you are.
Yeah.
I'll carry you around as long as you live. But I'm not fucking watering you.
You still on that?
Oh, it's, yeah, it's on.
Let me pull my dick out, man.
It's huge.
Well, gets the job done.
Oh, you've got three kids. You got, you know what you're doing with.
Shovel it in.
We're filthy.
I found those two briefcases over some like dump. I don't want them. I don't. They're kind of cool though. But all I'm gonna do is
dude, fucking Craigslist that shit.
Bleach them out and drop them off at some hipster ass fucking thrift store for that. And I'm like, look, I'll give them to you for $5. I'm in town. Either that or I'll do something with them.
Yeah, I'm telling you.
They make good displays.
Set up a, set up one of those fucking Etsy stores or some shit. And
yeah, Lori used to do that shit. And she was always really...
Just for some extra cash, you know? You don't even have to put your name on it or anything if you don't want it to be your legacy or whatever.
I was always beating her over the head about... Less Etsy, more street. Like First Fridays.
Yeah.
I told her, she had some really nice briefcases like the same era.
It's like, just take everything you got, stick it in, compartmentalize it, label it, put it in a briefcase. I got a table for you. Hop it up on the street, on Broad Street. She made a fair amount of money and got a lot of contacts, and then that's how she got her shit in the Quirk Hotel, and was it Quirk or Quark? Always fuck it up.
Got me, bro.
I can't remember if it's a physics thing or a fucking champagne thing, but yeah, it's like, just make it tasty. Take it or leave it. She made a fair amount of money. She only did it once. Fucking.
She's not like this.
All that happened as a result of it. She's just too distracted, I guess, with the 9-to-5.
I think there are a lot of people in the world who are scared to succeed, too. I really believe. I used to not think that. I'm like, who doesn't want to fucking succeed? But I think there are a lot of people who are scared.
Yeah, she had product built up out the ass because she had an Etsy store. She was trying to build up stuff that she could just, if somebody made an order, she could throw it out.
Was she reclusive? Maybe she just didn't like the idea of, or antisocial a little bit. Didn't like the idea of having to deal with strangers.
Yeah, there's probably a little of that. Definitely not a problem to me. Although I'm reclusive in areas. Just depends on how I feel about myself, I guess. Same with her, probably. But yeah, she could do that once a month and make another 100 or 200 a month just in spending 6 hours in the right spot. And she was all nervous about it, being like, I don't have a panhandler's license or whatever and all this. So what? You know?
Yeah, they shut you down and kick you out. So what?
Blonde-haired, good-looking girl that pretends not to know, it's just gonna get a warning. You know? She didn't get that. It's like, no, just do it.
Yeah.
Go with it until you have to apologize.
You've been given this privilege. Don't squander it.
Hey, Doug.
Don't squander it.
God damn, that song feels good. What you got planned?
I gotta go by Lowe's fucking house maintenance, man. Damn door sweep got torn off in the back door. Bugs coming in like crazy. Get to fix that.
Do you have a problem with the little ants?
We have ants. They're not.
You do anything about them? Got any solution for them?
Bruce eats them every now and then.
Bruce can take care of some ants.
He'll get up there and I'll see him like.
Get that protein.
I'm like, what are you doing? Eating ants.
I used to eat roly-polies.
And I'm like.
In Texas.
Really?
Fuck yeah. I didn't know better.
I've never eaten a roly-poly.
They told me to stop eating the pill, but I learned 20 years later they're called pill bugs. But I used to eat the shit out of them.
It's fucking foreshadowing if I ever heard of it.
I don't know. What do you mean?
Ryan's out there. What's Ryan doing? Yeah, popping pill bugs.
Okay, gotcha. Not much on the pills.
Yeah. I had a buddy in Covington who my back was messed up for a bit. I still haven't ever seen a chiropractor about it. I just try and stretch in the evening. But, oh shit, the window's closed. You got the AC on, right?
Yeah, might as well.
And, anyway, it was all messed up. I couldn't hardly get out of bed. So I got flexor roll. Yeah, cutting wood for like 8 hours one day. I got some flexor roll and that shit, dude, I felt like I had a case of beer. I mean, it was, just put me on my ass. So I stopped taking it, and I just hit the Tylenol and ibuprofen pretty heavy. Well, a guy at work.
This shit used to come around when I was in 10th grade.
Flexoril?
Just the hardcore opiates. Like, some pals of ours. They just show up, take one of these. Fucking do it.
Yeah.
Not just like float through class or something, you know?
Yeah, I've never been big on. I was thinking about that the other day too. Even if all this shit wasn't illegal, I don't need the government to tell me what's good or bad for my body. You know what I mean?
That's the way I've always been. I mean, I was Wild West, just reckless. But if I feel like I need something, I'm going to do it. Whether it's recreation or therapeutic.
Yeah. I think that's why I've never really done it. So I worry I wouldn't have control.
Something my dad seemed afraid of too. Him being a product of an alcoholic father. He says he's been drunk less than he can count on his hands. And he hated the control, the loss of control. So I can relate to that in the sense of the early times when I was drunk and having that still picturesque memory of it, but being that drunk, sort of almost seeing myself from a third perspective, and totally can understand where he's coming from. But at the same time, that's probably why I do it. Is to have that loss.
My dad's never been a big drinker. I don't think it wasn't really so much the loss of control as I was scared I was really going to hurt somebody. Because I can't remember ever having just fully let loose. Ever. You know what I mean? Like, in a fight or whatever. There's always been a reserve. Because, I mean, the way I look at it, I'm smart enough and creative enough that if I ever do get in a fight, I'm going to win. I've been in a lot of fights, but I've never lost a fight either.
Yeah, I can't say I've lost a one-on-one fight.
Right. And I guess that's the thing, is I'd be scared if it gets to the point where if I've lost control that much and I get in that situation, that's like fair game for your head. That, you know, whatever. That curve's fair game for your head. You know, little things like that that I just
don't... Yeah, if it's because of the booze or the drugs, then it's not good.
Right. Exactly.
But if it's because you're afraid...
And that's different. But I always wonder how much clearer mind am I going to have when I'm not on something. Yeah. I don't like that. I've definitely gotten drunk plenty, but it's always been... people I trust and setting I trust. I can't get drunk in public,
Yeah, I've definitely gotten to the point of realizing that I have to be careful what aspects of myself I reveal to people, whether that's an inebriated state or just an honest state or just anything. So I don't mind getting a little drunk. If I'm in the right state of mind at the bar and I can walk home, ride a bike home.
Yeah.
But it's definitely a lot different than it used to be. Where it was just get fucked up because what the hell else you got to do? And then all that angst and hatred, and mostly hatred for yourself, at least that I had to deal with, I think. Just being out of control. Begin with. Sober. It's like, here I am, and I had no real choice in it.
Whatever that is, self-hatred, I guess you could call it, always manifested, not in, I was never trying to escape it. I was trying to find something more real. And I think that's true of any cutter. I don't know, just my experience, I think that's true of anything. Inside fucking, of all about it.
Yeah. Just,
the pain was more real than whatever pathetic self I thought I was feeling.
Yeah.
And almost made you feel more alive to... What? Yeah, I don't know.
The first time I really sliced myself up... Look at my fucking face, man. With a pair of scissors. I just went shoink. And I was able to dismiss it with
oh, it was somebody's fingernail. Something like that. And then, I don't think I did anything super
cutting edge
until after Kyle, I did these like little things where I was painting with him.
Yeah.
And then I did the piece where I just fucking took a razor and sliced that and smeared it all over the place. That's been the extent of it. Grabbed this one girl's arm recently. I won't mention her name, but there's an orbit there. So I see her like tattooed arm. She's got these marks, and I just was like, oh, did you burn yourself with a curling iron? And she just stops, and she's one reason I admire her so much is she's just honest. I used to cut myself. She's like 15 or something. I'll look a little closer, and just like, it's like covered up with like a tiger and all this. I mean, a really well done tattoo, but the surface.
Star is just, yeah.
Surface stuff is there, and it, well, it looks nice. Doesn't bother me, like, especially since she's not ashamed of it. She's like, all right, well, you don't do that anymore, right? No.
Yeah, I guess that's my thing. Even when I get down now, it's not that. Not that I want it. Kind of like the tattoo thing. I haven't found anything cool in it. Like, if I was, I'd have to be in that state of mind that I'm like, you know what, this is going to be fucking awesome. I'm going to cut it into myself. Scarification. And there's just nothing.
Can you kind of do a little tattoo kind of?
Yeah, it's still
the
there.
Cross?
It's still there.
What did you do to, what were you puncturing with?
No, I sliced it open.
And then put indie ink in it?
I forged a knife. Sharpened the knife, cut it open, and then used charcoal that I had made.
Okay.
Oh, it was all very fucking, very origins, you know?
Yeah.
And then I got pissed because the corners didn't turn out nice. So I went back and resliced it. Sharpened the knife differently so it had a sharp point, went back, resliced it so I could get the corners. It's all, I mean, over the years, I mean, you can see there's a little bit of it left.
Yeah.
But this part is gone.
Yeah, you can tell it's like the parallel lines.
There's
yeah.
Double cross or an cross. Yeah.
On the left forearm too, yeah. See these, I did three or four to begin with, yeah. Went, just like impulses, it was like, chick, 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 chick. And they sealed up real quick. I couldn't do anything with them. So that was that. And then I thought about it a little bit, and I was thinking about how the Romans would kill themselves. Take a hot bath. So I took a hot bath. Went really deep. And then came with that. Got a lot more blood that way.
Yeah, I found... I mean, that knife, I mean, it was fucking sharp. But skin's really tough. And so when I cut it, I got a nice clean cut. But in order to get it to go deep, I had to sit there and hold it and then drag very slowly to get any kind of... It's interesting because I've had people ask me about it in the past.
They spot it?
Yeah, some people spot it. To me, it's always there. You know, it stands out. But surprisingly, I've been at this mill for 3 years. The other mill, I had several people ask me about it. Never had anyone say anything this mill. It's interesting. I don't know if it's just one of those things that they look and go, "Yeah, I'm not asking the dude about that," or if they just don't notice. I don't know. But
I guess if you see it every day, you start to wonder. But it looks like just whatever, you know.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, and that's the other thing is it's lost so much of the charcoal out of it from early when I had done it.
Yeah, you really have to look at it close to realize that there's some shape to it. It's like a structure, you know?
I thought about having, like, be like a fucking forearm of, like, St. George and then just have that on a shield, you know, as a shield. Or
is it the serpent?
St. George was dragon, well, one of them, St. George's Dragon Slayer. Fucking have it, that the shield and then him behind him, fucking dragon going down the wrist or something, a snake going down the wrist.
I think I thought about getting a, like, lasered, like the removal where they bust up the ink. Just let your body take care of it.
Nah, doesn't bother me, really.
I remember having lead. There were assholes in, like, first grade. I can't remember what the game was. It was like, and it would just stab your fucking hand.
And then you got a fucking lead tattoo.
Then you have a lead piece of carbon stuck in you.
Yeah.
I had one of those in, like, first grade. That might be it right there. Things, man.
Yeah.
Well, you want any whiskey or gin or?
Nah, like I said, I gotta get to Lowe's. I would probably, I don't know, whatever day you're gonna put the plants away, whenever you get the plants, just put them in. I'll probably run that through and try and go slow and get it as deep as you can.
Get it real deep.
I don't know, with, like I said, with all the rocks and with all the organic stuff in it, I don't know that you're gonna get much deeper, but.
Yeah, well, we've gotta. We can take it by a plant by plant basis and just fucking shovel up what I need to.
But yeah, so squash, tomatoes, green beans, peppers, all those. I mean, you really haven't missed much.
She has some rosemary in the front that just fucking fried itself, I think. There's not enough water. More shade or something. I would think rosemary would be pretty resistant, but I don't know when the last whatever that plant is, I got it from Laura's parents. It was a root shop. That fucker grows fast, man. It'll put out two more leaves now that it's in the sun.
What's that Swiss cheese plant back there?
The little pot.
Choke it, give it a pull or two until you hear it try and turn over.
That's what likes you better.
Switch it over to run.
Yeah, see, I'm doing that. That's what I've been doing.
Try to run.
Yeah.
of start watching around.
From 7 to 8, I can live. Depending on the brand. Like,
but I would have grabbed a couple of strings off of them. He's in black.
figure out some fucking food. Occasionally I do eat rather than drink. I don't know what the hell I have. I'm tempted to commandeer some of these fucking fridge items. Those eggplant fucking veggie burgers look fucking delicious. Breaded green beans veggie burger. Italian ices, assorted flavors. Oh, thank you. Oh, damn. There's a York peppermint fucking patty here that I bought for Melissa and she forgot about. It's so hard not to eat that. Alright. I'm gonna eat the fucking shit out of some eggplant cutlets. Herbie's vegan. But he's not here till August, so. I think I can replenish his eggplant cutlets. I'm not laughing at his veganism. I just like. I just think the name is fucking hilarious. Eggplant cutlets. I'm sure they're fucking awesome. Otherwise I wouldn't eat them. I just think it's a fucking hilarious thing. Eggplant cutlets. I don't know, it's like the veganism thing is fine. The terminology and like these phrases of associating things with just fucking call them compiled eggplant thingies. I'd be more inclined to buy that myself as somebody that now eats meat rather egg eggplant. Because I'm sure they're fucking delicious. I mean, eggplant, damn it. Like, I need some cucumbers and I mean, it's fucking like Baba Ganoush fucking burger. Call it that. That sounds cool. Bob, it's got alliteration. Baba Ganoush burgers. Eggplant cutleries, you're fucking up, dude. You are fucking up. Eggplant cutlery. No, Trader Joe, hey, listen to me. And you should pay me about, I don't know, $500,000 a year. But, eggplant cutlery? No. Not, no, no. Don't, no, 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 no. Your research department knows better. They just don't care. Eggplant cutlery? Come on now. Come on now. Baba Ganoush burgers.
Kit, kit. Kit, kit. What are you doing?
take plant cutlets.
I'm drunk as shit. I can hear my southern accent. I know I'm fucking wasted if I'm talking like a fucking hillbilly. Cutlets.
Woo!
Oh shit. Some cancer on him, shit. But wait a minute, it's safe to clean. Chickpeas, what do you want? A little more olive oil.
Sun is coming in wonderfully. I don't know if you can see the blades of it or not. It's definitely slicing in here. Especially with the smoke now. Yeah, there we go. See that? My glass out of the way. Quite a nice little scene here. Alright, so, hey.